Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on SAP API Management. In this video, I'm going to talk about the components of API Management. We'll try to learn what are the different components of API Management and what are the different roles in API Management and how each role will interact with the component of API Management. So without further delay, let's begin. So as I discussed in the previous video, let's quickly start with three questions. You don't need to know the answers now. At the end of the video, you'll be able to answer all the three questions. Let's begin. The first question is, which component in API Management layer is responsible for developing APIs? What type of APIs can interact with the backend, database, and cloud services in the diagram? What action is associated with API admins and owners in the API Management lifecycle? So what are components of API Management? Before we begin, let's talk about different roles and users that we have in API Management. For example, when you work with API Management, the role can be an application. So it can be an IoT application, or it can be a mobile device, or it can be any web application. So basically, this application consumes the APIs, and we have a role called API admin, or it can be a owner. So the action this API admin and owner does is he or she manages the APIs or monetizes the APIs. The third role is, for example, he or she can be an application developer. In this case, application developer tries to engage with API Management. The next role or user is API admin, or he also can be owner. So he also performs like analyzing the API performance or key metrics. Another role can be API developer, who actually develops the APIs in API Management. So we have consume, manage, engage, analyze, or develop. These are the actions that a specific user or role performs in API Management. What we'll do now is we'll try to look at the components of API Management and how these roles and users related to each component. So let's start with API developer. The job of this API developer is to develop APIs in API Management. So the corresponding component is API designer. API developer uses API designer to design and develop APIs in API Management. So the next role is API admin or owner. He or she wants to analyze APIs. Then the component is API analytics. This is the component responsible for API analytics. The other role is application developer. So basically, application developer engages with API Management component. He searches, discovers, and uses and retrieves the APIs, right? So the corresponding component is API Business Hub Enterprise. In olden days, we have something called service registry, which is used to store the enterprise services, and we used to look up and search and discover. And similarly, we have something called API Business Hub, where we store all the APIs in a given organization. It can be SAP API or non-SAP API. What developers does is, if you're an application developer from other system or from other component, you first look up in API Business Hub. If you find the API, consume it. So you basically, you engage with that system. And the corresponding system is API Business Hub Enterprise. The next role is API admin or owner. In this case, he manages or monetize the APIs. The corresponding component is API management design time. So this is one of the components that is responsible for managing, metering, and monetizing APIs. Finally, we have applications that actually consumes API from API management. The corresponding component is API management runtime. So here, when you say API management runtime, for example, in SAPCPI, when you create an API, it usually asks for a runtime, right? And typically there are three different types of runtimes we have in API runtimes. They are CPI runtime, PO runtime, and edge integration cell runtime. A runtime where you want to execute the API, you need to choose the corresponding API runtime when you create an API in SAP CPI. Okay, so these are the three runtimes, remember that. Now, so we have consumers, we have API as a middle layer, and we should have a backend, which actually handles the service request from the consumers. So usually what we do, we usually create three different types of services, or data service, or REST service, or it can be SOAP service. So by using these services, we try to connect to the backend system. The backend system can be any application. It can be a cloud application, or it can be an on-premise application, or it can be a database server. It can be any application in the backend. We expose the services from these backend services and we store them and manage them in the API management. So we mainly have five components. One is API management runtime, API management design time, API business hub enterprise, API analytics, and API designer. So that's it about the components of API management. So now let's look at the questions again and try to answer the questions. And if you know the answer, give me a comment in the comment section. If you don't know the answer, go back and watch the video again. I hope you learned something new in this video. If you like the video, consider giving a like, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for watching.